Carpenter. I'm going to see Johnny Cash.
Jim Carpenter.
Me.
fighting above. His dear arms around me are loving to catch. Sweetly he tells his love. The tempest is over. I'm safe evermore. What gladness, what rapture is mine. The danger is past. I'm anchored in land. I'm anchored in love's mind. Lord, he saw me in danger and he lovingly came. I lift my storm-beaten soul. Has offered and blessed his dear name. Billows go long and roll. The tempest is o'er. I'm safe evermore. What gladness, what rapture is mine. The danger is past. I'm anchored at last. Blood shall control me through life and in death. Completely I'll trust to the end. I'll praise him each hour of my last fleeting breath. Sing of my soul's best friend. The tempest is o'er. I'm safe evermore. What gladness, what rapture is mine. The
I've never had the privilege of getting to introduce Johnny Cash, so I asked Mother if I could tonight. The reason I wanted to personally thank him and Jim for all that they've done for Janette, Joe, and the Carter Fold. If it wasn't for a lot of what they've done to help keep this going, it wouldn't be going. So again, I really appreciate everything they've done. And if y'all would please make welcome Johnny Cash.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
It's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine. I don't know when I'm stuck at Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on down San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. In a fancy
dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me. That railroad train was mine. Bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let the lonesome whistle blow my blues away. This is home to us, and we come home, and we just squat all over you. It's just really nice to be with you. I want to thank you for the kind words there, Dale, but always know that it's our pleasure to come up and be on the fold.
Thank you, Donner.
I'd like to say happy birthday to Jerry Hensley. His birthday yesterday, and today it's his sister Sue's birthday. Yeah. Happy birthday, honey. And I want to thank Joe Carter tonight for a great gift today. This handmade mulberry guitar. Joe Carter, he gave it to me.
Thank you.
with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the song that they were singing. I headed down the road, somewhere far away, a lonely bell was ringing. And it echoed through the canyons like a disappearing dream of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes a body feel alone. There ain't nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk. Sunday morning coming down. I'd like to thank Bugs for coming back, being with us second Saturday night. You're a bear for punishment there, man. And Tommy, thanks Tommy for a good job on the beat. When you get the blue, you get rock and roll feeling in your bones, taps on your toes and get gone, get a rhythm. When you get the blue, a little shoe shine boy never could slow down, got the dirtiest job in town, bending low at the people's feet on a windy corner of the dirty street. Well, I asked you while they shine my shoes how to keep from getting the blues. Red is a racist little head about the shoe shine rag. Then you say, get a rhythm. When you get the blues, come on, get a rhythm. When you get the blues, get a rock and roll feeling in your bones, taps on your toes and get gone, get a rhythm. When you get the jump with joy. Slapped on the sheep while he slept and right. Took his shine rag and he held it tight. He stopped once to wipe the sweat away. Said, you're right, little boy, to be working that way. Said, I like it, with a big wide grin. Kept on the pumping and he said again, get rhythm. When you get the blues, come on, get a rhythm. When you get the blues, it only costs a dime, a nickel a shoe, doesn't make your dollars worth of good for you. Get a rhythm. When you get the
world.
I remember 1957. I can remember farther back than that, but I remember 1957. I was on Red Foley's Ozark Jubilee, Springfield, Missouri. And Red had been doing a thing called Suppertime that I just love. And I did this with Red that night. Suppertime in a key of A, Jerry. Many years ago, in days of childhood, I used to play till evening time would come. Still winding down that old familiar pathway, I hear my brother call at setting sun. Come home, come home, it's supper time. The shadows lengthen fast. Come home, come home, it's supper time. We're going home at last. Some of the fondest memories of my childhood are woven around supper time. When mother used to call from the back steps of the old home place, come on home now, son, it's supper time. How I'd love to hear that once again. But you know, time has woven for me the realization of a truth even more thrilling, that someday we'll be called together around the great saber table up there for the greatest supper time of them all with our Lord. I can almost hear the call now, coming from the portals of heaven. Come home at supper time. The shadows lengthen fast. Come home, it's supper time. We're going home. All the songs we talked about doing and rehearsed and ran down and mentioned, that was one we did not mention. You can tell me, by the way, I didn't get with the band on that one, that I didn't get a rehearsal with them on it. But I will detain you not much longer for the star of the show, because she will be right out. She come back to this valley to do some recordings, along with that, with coming home and all that, to do some recordings for an upcoming CD of her own. But I'm going to let her tell you all about it. She's here to entertain you right now tonight on this particular part of her visit, and I'm here to do what I can to help her. Please make welcome June Carter. I'm just fine, thank you. How you doing?
Good. The top part of me is good, and the I don't know about the bottom part of it. I'm not being able to see down that far. I'm always glad to come home. And John comes with me wherever I go, and I go with him wherever he goes, and we just paddle all over the world. We've been doing that for a long time. I came in over there tonight, and I thought, well, I'll just walk in here like any of the girls. And I got real dressed up, and I forgot to put on my shoes. These are big old cloppers, and they're not going to work with what I've got plans for tonight. Well, see, I thought if I just came in the front door and acted like I was somebody, you know, I could get through there and nobody would know. And I'm just slithering along, kind of flying through there. And I felt myself right over there, and this one woman, she grabbed me and she said, "Long Willow!" I said, "No, honey, I'm not Loretta, bless your heart. I'm not her at all. Because I wouldn't have Johnny if I was Loretta. I was born in this valley just about a mile up the road. It's too much of my heart that's a part of this place. That lady never did get up on me. She never did give up. She just kind of glared at me and she said, "Yeah, you're little Jenny Carter, all right. That's you." She stood back and kept looking at me and glared. She said, "Well, you got fat, didn't you?" Wrong way. So we got up closer to the mirror and she watched me while I just bounced the fluid around. And that's what you can do, you see? You just go along fine until you get a little bit older and the first thing you know, you eat everything you can get your hands on. Starting with dessert. I tell you, I thought, "Well, I'll get you. You just won't give up on me." She wouldn't give up on me. And I kept staring at her. And I said, "Well, what can I do for you? What's wrong? What can I do for you?" She said, "Well, I just don't hardly know, honey." She said, "I tell you how it is. That I was thinking we could get over here closer to the mirror, we could get a better look at you." She said, "No." I said, "No, this is just fluid. Now I can skinny it up here if I keep trying." So I stood there and skinnied my fluid up as best I could. I held my breath and just pulled everything up this way. So I got to doing a little bit better. She said, "Yeah, you're doing pretty good there. So just a little higher and you'll be all right." And I said, "Well, I'm not the one that's, why am I doing this? What's the matter with you?" She said, you're just plumb skinny." She was going to talk about me being fat. I was going to talk about her being skinny. And I said, "You're just plumb skinny. That's all there is to it. Get down there and lay low like a log. Let me see you there. You're skinny." She said, "Well, I am kind of that way, but that's the way it is in the magazines now." She said, I just go on trying to be that way." And she got up closer to me and she said, "Oh my goodness." Said, "You poor little thing." Said, "You're right." Said, "You're not really skinny. You are fat." Said, "But it all comes together in this valley and it just ping-pongs all around this part of the country." Said, "I'll tell you what," said, "Well, you're as picky as anybody I've ever seen now, because I was getting white now. Just right around the eyes, I was getting white." And she said, "Yep, you're picky." I said, "Well, okay, here I am coming at you, picky." So she said, "I tell you," she said, "if you get up there to the mirror and look, you can just do a little bit better," said. "What you need is a sweet tater, a big sweet tater." And I got up there pretty close, and she said, "No, wait a minute." Got her little head in there, and she said, just give me that sweet tater. She said, "Why, you poor little bitty thing looking in that mirror." Said, "You've been doing that for a long time, and that's my sweet tater." And said, looked at the mirror again and said, "Well, I tell you what." Said, "I think I'll just have that sweet tater myself." Only, it didn't work. Just didn't work. She was. Have you ever started doing something and just couldn't remember what you're doing? Janette and Joe. We were double first cousins. That's because Mom and Aunt Sarah were first cousins, and then they married brothers. And then I don't know what happened after that. I claim everybody in this valley, so I'm close to all of you, and I appreciate you letting me do that. I wasn't quite sure I was coming on this fast. You want me to sing? Why, you just be quiet a bit, or you can sing. It's gonna be quiet. Don't have a stool. I'm gonna fall down. Don't see shoes I've got on. I try to pick them up, and they weigh about 5 pounds a piece. Okay, thank you very much. Let me get down here. Get right over here. Come on, girls. Oh, that's not a girl. Oh, I tell you, I hope I'll never get in that hole again where I was a minute ago. I always worried that would happen to me, and I believe that's the worst time. First time it ever really did. I brought my auto harp, and Joe was talking to you about me recording up here. This last week, I came up to record for my son's my producer, John Carter Cash, and he's kind of a slave driver. And about half of my album, I wanted to do some songs of the Carter family. And you know, I love the songs. Everybody sings about them. Everybody knows most all of those songs. But I've decided to sing some songs for you tonight that you've never heard before. This ought to get us little bit of stuff going on. I wonder where my legs will go if I just get a better note. Are you coming up here close, honey? Johnny, what I'm going to do, I did this with all of the family that was close to me beside Janette and Joe and Dale that are singing. My daughter Carlene and my granddaughter Tiffany Lowe and Anita's daughter Lori. We did this thing together. You see, we're too old to stand up. We're both here together now. All right. I'm not having a good time up here. I got it. right there. All these little holes in the top of that, full of fish hooks. Nothing makes me feel better than to hear Janette and Dale and Joel sing Acrid in Love. Johnny, you're going to have to be a Carter brother on this.
All right.
Because...
All right.
Okay. Well, I just like to sing some of these songs and maybe leave them to you. Carter family left so many of their great classic songs, and they're still with us all around the world. And that's amazing that they came out of this little valley. It really is. So I wanted to play you some songs that they had that you had never heard. And then I wanted to leave some, too, for them. So if you've never heard this, you just have to learn them. Because I'll be singing them every time I open my mouth. Here we go, Johnny. Okay.
Story here to die in Cuba. Jackson.
See if I can.
Well, when I breeze into
that city, people gonna scrape and bow. All them women gonna make me teach them what they don't know how. I'm gonna be set. You turn the lips of my coat. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson.
Goodbye, that's all she wrote. Well, I left you in Jackson. I'll be dancing on the pony cake. Police round town, let's start it. Hang with your tails up between your legs. Yeah, go to Jackson. You big talking man.
Was with us for many, many years when we were
playing on the road together, and I'm thankful that he remembers all the songs and made up a few of them. It just means a lot to a lot of us, and just pick the one you want to be sung for.
I believe my steps are growing wearier each day. Got another journey on my mind. Lures of this old world pleased to make me want to stay. And my one regret is leaving you behind.
But if it proves to be his will, then I am first to cross. And somehow I've a feeling it will be. When it comes your time to travel, likewise don't feel lost. For I will be the first one that you'll see.
And I'll be waiting on the far side banks of Jordan. I'll be sitting, drawing pictures in the sand. And when I see you coming, I will rise up with a shout and come running through the shallow water, reaching for your hand. Through this life we labor hard to earn our meager fare. It's brought us trembling hands and failing eyes.
So I'll just rest here on this shore and turn my eyes away. Until you come, then we'll see paradise.
And I'll be waiting on the far side banks of Jordan. I'll be sitting, drawing pictures in the sand. And when I see you coming, I will rise up with a shout and come running through the shallow water, reaching for your hand.
Janette is going away on a trip that is going to be a wonderful thing for her. I think most of you know that she is going to be honored for the songs of the Carter family, and she'll be going to London. It's by the University of London, and we played there so many times. Janette, I'm excited for you. You will have a great time. They'll love you. They really will. Well, they're going to.
Rita has asked me also to announce that there's going to be a receptacle of some kind right here on the stage where you could make a donation and donate money for the removal of the house, the log house, in the Little Valley, to bring it over here and make it a part of the Carter family fold right here by the museum and the show place here, the fold. So I would like to ask all of you, if you can, sometime tonight, to bring money down and put it in the kitty, wherever the kitty's going to be.
Meow, meow.
There's going to be a kitty down here, Rita.
Oh, it's over there.
Oh, where are you going to be, Rita?
This is the old home place of the Carter family. My father was born there, and Uncle A.P. Carter was born there, all of the family. Yeah, all of us played there with Grandma Carter. It's a little cabin built with logs back over in the Little Valley. Belongs to Fern Sayer and her brother Roger Carter. So they're going to allow Janette and them to kind of move it out here, or Fern will tell us where to put it. If you do that, that would be good. But at any rate, they need some money to make the transition for the little cabin to come out here. Yeah. Okay, we've got a... Okay, I would do this. Come on, Joe. You, Janette, you want to come up for this? Or you? We're going to do one that we've done together once before. Okay, you sure?
Come on, Joe.
Joe sits on our porch every morning and waits for lunch.
Well, I remember when I was a lad, times were hard and things were bad. But there's a silver lining to hide every cloud. And just poor people, that's all we were, trying to make a living out of black thunder. We get together in a family circle and sing out loud. They sing this.
I'll sing a tenor.
In the room, you're right in there. Go sing and sing to help our troubled soul. He says it won't be long. I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. Oh, no, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by. Daddy, sing bass.
Mama, sing. Who sung tenor? Mama sing tenor.
Me and little brother and yours right in there. In the sky, Lord, in the sky. Play it, Jerry. For a country mile. Now little brother's done gone on. I'll rejoin them in a song. We'll be together again up yonder a little while. Daddy, you sing bass.
Mama sang a tenor.
Me and little brother would join right in there. Cause singing seems to help us trouble so. One of these days it won't be long. I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne.
Oh no, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by.
Daddy, sing bass.
Mama, sing tenor.
Me and little brother, John, right in there. In the sky, Lord, in the sky. In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
They just come and work, you know? You keep